To create a document in Google Drive, go to drive.google.com. This is also where you can access all of your files that you've already created. Click the New button and select Google Documents. An untitled document will be created and saved in Google Drive automatically. You can label your document here. And it's always saved automatically. You can export this then to a Microsoft Word file, .x, and will always be the latest version. Open document format, rich text format, PDF document, plain text, and web page. Another way to create a new document and see other Google templates for documents is by going to docs.google.com. Here you will see a list of templates or be able to create a new blank document, as well as a filtered view of documents only in your Google Drive by anyone. There are many benefits to using Google Drive to create your files. Your settings, applications, and files go where you go, and they're always backed up and maintained to the latest version for everyone. You can see a revision history and revert to that version anytime. Just click the file in the document and see revision history. Then preview those revisions and select the one that you want. Remember, only the owner who creates the file can delete it, and you can share this in real time with your colleagues on any device, anywhere, anytime. Sharing documents is what sets a Google document apart, allowing you to collaborate with someone else in real time without having to worry about what version of editor or file they are using. We can both go to a link stored on Google servers. Therefore, setting permissions when sharing a Google document with people becomes important. When you share a Google document, you can give them edit, comment, or view access to a document. If you don't know if the person you're sharing with a file has Google Apps or a Google account, or want to list this as a public link, you can get a shareable link here. Let's say we want to be able to post this link to this document on our website or Facebook page for anyone to look at. We can turn on link sharing to public on the web, searchable by Google or anyone with the link. Then copy the long URL and paste it wherever you want. Here's what the document looks like when it's viewed in a public link mode. You'll notice that there's no toolbars for anyone to make edits on this public link mode. As you can see, when you share with another Google user, you can edit these files together, so you're both on the same page. When someone else is editing a document, you can see their name highlighted above the text that they're editing. It's easy to use Google Documents when you use a Chrome browser. There's certain things that you can do in the Chrome browser that you can't with other browsers, like dragging and dropping images right onto the document from your desktop. It's also easy to work with those using other systems by allowing you to email your document as an attachment right from your document itself. Just click the file, email as attachment, and select the converted attachment. Email addresses populate right from Google Contacts, and you can send a copy to myself for further archiving in your Gmail inbox. When you store and backup files with Google Drive, you can even work with other apps like Google Photos and easily import pictures from Google Drive, pictures from your phone, or even do a quick Google search. Everything you need is right here in Google Drive. The new built-in photo editor using the image options allows you to quickly make adjustments to those photos without ever leaving the document. Available for collaborators to all see. Now you can focus on your content. And anyone can work with Google Documents.